Hola, yo soy la señorita Erika. Bienvenidos a Español para Niños de Brookline Interactive. Hi everyone, welcome to Spanish for Children. I'm Miss Erika, señorita Erika, y vamos a continuar nuestro estudio de español como todas las semanas. Y vamos a primero comenzar con nuestro calentamiento para practicar el español que sabemos, o bueno, si ustedes ya no estuvieron aquí, que no saben, pero pueden saltar para juntarse con nosotros. So we're going to start with a little warm-up for those of you who have been here before to review what we know before, what that we have learned before. For those of you who are brand new, that's totally fine. You're welcome to just jump in with us and kind of catch up with some of the things that we've been learning before we go into the new material. So vamos a preparar un poco con el alfabeto. So we always start with a little bit of the alphabet to remind us ourselves of the letters in the Spanish alphabet, the different sounds of Spanish. So vamos a repetir juntos: A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, Y, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Muy bien, excelente trabajo. Y ahora unos números. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Muy bien. Okay, y ahora con los días de la semana, the days of the week. Maybe if you've been with us, you remember a song that we learned together many classes ago to remember the days of the week. And it's a song that involves some snaps, or if you can't snap, you can clap along. The tune goes. And now with the days of the week, remember it starts with domingo. There's domingo and there's lunes. There's martes and miércoles. There's jueves and viernes. And then there's sábado. Days of the week. 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 Muy bien. Y ahora con los meses del año. Again, we're just kind of we're rocketing through a bunch of the things we've learned together. Los meses del año with the months of the year. This is all part of our calentamiento, our warm-up. So we also learned a song for the months of the year, and it came with some motions. So hopefully you can, if you know them, you can jump in and follow along. And if you don't know them, you can jump in and follow along. So enero, febrero, marzo, abril, mayo, junio, julio, agosto, septiembre, octubre, noviembre, diciembre. 12 meses son. And those are the 12 months. Muy bien. Y dos cosas más. Los animales. The animals in Spanish. Los animales. We have gato. Meow. Gato. Perro. Woof, woof. So repeat this along with me. Perro. Pájaro. Tweet, tweet, tweet. Pájaro. Caballo. Caballo. Nay. Vaca. Vaca. Mu. Ratón. Ratón. Squeak, 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 squeak. Gallina. Gallina. Cluck, 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 cluck. Mono. Mono. Cerdo. Cerdo. Elefante. Elefante. Jirafa. Jirafa. León. León. Muy bien. Y la cosa fina con vocabulario son los colores. Los colores. The colors. We have rojo. Rojo. Red. Naranja. Naranja. Orange. Amarillo. Amarillo. Yellow. Verde. Verde. Green. Azul. Azul. Blue. Púrpura. Púrpura. Purple. Rosa. Rosa. Pink. Marrón. Marrón. Brown. Negro. Negro. Black. Gris. Gris. Gray. And blanco. Blanco. White. Muy bien. Ok. Y unos verbos para calentarnos. A few verbs, some action words that we've learned together. So we have, yo tengo, I have, yo tengo. Yo no tengo, I don't have. Yo no tengo. Yo quiero, I want. Yo quiero. Yo no quiero, I don't want. Yo no quiero. Yo soy, I am. Yo soy. Yo no soy, I'm not. Yo no soy. También sabemos cómo decir me gusta, I like, me gusta, or no me gusta, I don't like, no me gusta. Muy bien. Y unos verbos finales, yo llevo, I'm wearing, I wear, yo llevo. We also learn yo practico, I practice, yo practico. Yo juego, I play, yo juego. And yo voy, I go, yo voy. Muy bien, ok, estamos bien calentados. We're well warmed up and ready to learn some more Spanish. Ok, so vamos a comenzar con un repasito de los lugares. So we're going to start our lesson today with a little review of the places that we have been learning in Spanish, los lugares. So we're going to do a quick review and then play a game. So los lugares are places in Spanish. So vamos a repetir juntos. We're going to repeat together first the different places in Spanish. So we have first, and for those of you who have been with us, hopefully these should be sounding really familiar to you by now. And if you're new, no problem. You can still jump in with us. Casa. Casa. House. Escuela. Escuela. School. Hospital, 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 farmacia, pharmacy, farmacia, tienda, tienda, store, panadería, panadería, bakery, iglesia, iglesia, church. Parque, parque, park. Restaurante, restaurante, restaurant. Mercado, mercado, market. Muy bien. And so for those of you who are spellers, we're going to give you a little something to do como, with our cómo se deletrea, how do you spell? So if you are a speller, if you know how to spell with your Spanish letters, feel free to jump in and try to spell faster than me. If you are not a speller quite yet, or you're not big on spelling, no worries, you can follow along and you can repeat after me. So cómo se deletrea casa, how do we spell casa en español? C A S. A. Casa. ¿Cómo se deletrea escuela? How do we spell escuela en español? E. S. C. U. E-L-A. Escuela. Now you can see why we reviewed the Spanish alphabet at the start of class, because it would come in handy. ¿Cómo se deletrea hospital? H-O-S-P-I-T-A-L. Hospital. Hospital. Muy bien. ¿Cómo se deletrea farmacia? How do we spell farmacia or pharmacy, which is the place where you can get medicine? F-A-R-M-A-C-I-A. Farmacia. ¿Cómo se deletrea tienda? Tienda. T-I-E. N, T, A, tienda. Muy bien, good work. ¿Cómo se deletrea panadería? This one's a little challenging. Panadería. P, A, N, A, D, E, R, I, A. Panadería. Bakery. Muy bien. ¿Cómo se deletrea iglesia? Iglesia. I. G. L. E. S. I. A. Iglesia. ¿Cómo se deletrea parque? P. A. R, Q, U, E. Parque. ¿Cómo se deletrea restaurante? R, E, S, T, A, U, R, A, N, T, E. Restaurante. And last one, mercado. ¿Cómo se deletrea mercado? M, E, R, C, A, D, O. Mercado. Muy bien. Okay, excelente trabajo. Excellent work. Now, for those of you who were with us last time, you remember we spoke about a game. We played a little bit of it, but we're going to play a little bit more today. And I also welcome you to play a little bit, to play more at home as well for our places, our lugares game in Spanish. So the way we play this game is you can play either by yourself or you can play with other people. Is someone who is the leader of the game is going to say the name of a place in Spanish. And then the people who are playing the game have to act out what you do at this place. So we're going to play a little bit today together. So listos, ready? So if you can play sitting in your seat, or if you want to stand up and move around a little bit, you can do. Just make sure that you are being safe in the space that you're in. So and we're keeping all of the same kind of rules we would keep in mind if we were in the classroom together. So this is a game where you cannot, there's no running allowed, so only walking feet. And you also, if you're inside, as probably you are, you want to make sure to use your inside voice. So no yelling or screaming while you're playing this game. Those are the two most important rules as we play this game and play it. It's fun, but we want to play it in a safe way. Especially if we're playing with other people, we need to make sure that we're interacting with them in a safe way. So vamos a jugar, let's play. So I'm going to say the name of a place in Spanish, and then I want you to act out what you do in that place. So we're just going to start with mercado. Mercado, or the market in Spanish. ¿Qué se hace? What do you do? ¿Qué se hace en el mercado? What do you do in the market? So act it out for me. Maybe you're looking at a plátano or a banana to see if it's ripe. You're looking at a sandía, a watermelon. Maybe you're going to look at a pepino, a cucumber. So we're looking at some frutas and vegetales, which we believe we learned together. So different fruits and vegetables, different foods. Looking at to see what we want to buy, okay, at the mercado, where we get all our comida fresca, our fresh food. ¿Qué se hace En el restaurante. So show me what you do in the restaurante. In a restaurant. Restaurante. Now, most of us are going to be eating, right? We're going to be sitting at a table eating. That's how we show what we do at the restaurante. Now, ¿qué se hace en el parque? What do you do in the parque? Parque, in the park, so it's about outside space where we can play. So maybe you're going to be playing some football, some soccer, or maybe you're going to be playing with a frisbee. Maybe you're going to just be running around, maybe playing some leapfrog, whatever it is you like to play at the parque. Okay, muy bien. Now, ¿qué se hace en la iglesia? So what do you do in the church? And as I said last time, some families go to church, some families don't go to church. Every family is different. So that's totally fine if your family doesn't go to church. And if you do, that's great too. So if you know about church, what did you do at church? ¿Qué se hace en la iglesia? So you might sit and listen, you might sing, you might pray. There are lots of different things we can do en la iglesia. Okay. ¿Qué se hace en la panadería? What do you do in the panadería, in the bakery? ¿Qué se hace en la panadería? What do you do in the bakery? Again, it's another place where maybe most of us are going to be eating to show what we do in the panadería. But maybe you're eating something already. Maybe you're picking something you want to buy. And there are lots of delicious things en la panadería. Okay, ¿qué se hace en la tienda? What do you do in the tienda, in the tienda? Tienda is a store. So this depending on what kind of store you're going to, you can be buying lots of different things. You could be buying ropa, like clothes. You could be buying materiales escolares. You could be buying school supplies. You can be buying lots of different things. So tienda, you choose what you want to be buying. Maybe if it's ropa, if it's clothes, you're trying them on, you're picking them out. You can do lots of different things to show what you do at that tienda. Okay, ahora con la farmacia. ¿Qué se hace en la farmacia? So what do you do at the farmacia or the pharmacy? The pharmacy is again usually where you would maybe buy some medicines, or you can also sometimes buy shampoo, other things for cleaning yourself. You can buy snacks. There are lots of things we have in the farmacia. So, ¿qué se hace en la farmacia? So show me, what do you do in la farmacia? Okay, muy bien. ¿Qué se hace en el hospital? What do you do in the hospital? The hospital is usually the place that people go when they're sick, or sometimes, or to have a baby too. Lots of different things, but usually we go to the hospital when we're sick. So, ¿qué se hace en el hospital? So, in an hospital, you can be either a patient, meaning you're a sick person, or maybe you can act as the doctor, the doctor, or the enfermera, the nurse in the hospital. Okay, ¿qué se hace en la escuela? What do you do in la escuela? Escuela, leemos libros, escribimos, comemos en la cafetería, jugamos en el gimnasio, or lots of different things we can show that we do at the escuela. Maybe we're reading, we're writing, we are going to be eating in the cafeteria. We're going to be reading a book in the library, doing some art in the art classroom, going to gym class. Again, lots of things we can do in la escuela. And last thing, ¿qué se hace en la casa? What do you do in the casa, in the house? Muchas cosas, right? We have lots of different things we could do in the casa. We could be leyendo un libro, we could be reading a book, podemos comer, podemos cepillarnos los dientes, podemos cepillarnos el pelo, podemos dormir. There are lots of different things that we can do en la casa. Okay, muy bien. Excelente trabajo. So there's our little review of the different places en español. Okay, vamos a seguir adelante. We're going to keep moving forward onto something brand new. We can definitely practice a little bit more with the transporte, either by playing more of the game we just, sorry, practice more with the lugares by playing more of this game that we just played where you act out what you do, or you can also practice, for example, with a drawing. So you can color something in or draw places you go and label it en español. Okay, ahora vamos a ir aquí. So we're going to be learning something new. But before we get to our new thing, we're going to read a little story called Permiso. Excuse me. Permiso. Okay. Permiso. So vamos a leer. We're going to read this. I'm going to read it first and then maybe repeat after me. Okay. And I'll tell you when to repeat. So permiso. Excuse me. Hola, por favor. ¿Cómo puedo llegar a la escuela? Preguntó Ana. Solo tienes que seguir esa calle hasta el final, girar a la izquierda y luego girar en la primera calle a la derecha, respondió Guillermo. Gracias, dijo Ana. I'm going to read it one more time and tell you in English what it's saying. So, permiso, excuse me. Hola, por favor. Hello, please. ¿Cómo puedo llegar a la escuela? How can I get to school? How can I arrive to school? Preguntó Ana. Ana asked. Solo tienes que seguir esa calle hasta el final. You just have to follow this street until the end. Girar a la izquierda, turn to the left, y luego girar en la primera calle a la derecha, and then turn in the first street on the right, responded Guillermo. Gracias, dijo Ana. Ana said, thanks. So as you can probably tell from this reading, what we're going to be learning, we're going to start learning some directions in Spanish. So vamos a repetir. Let's repeat a few of the key words from this reading. So Ana says, ¿cómo puedo llegar? Repita, ¿cómo puedo llegar? It's like, how can I get to? ¿Cómo puedo llegar? And then we have seguir la calle. Seguir la calle. Can you say with me? Seguir la calle. Follow the street. Okay. Girar, turn. Girar. Girar. Then we have izquierda, left. Izquierda, left. And then derecha, right. Derecha, right. So that just gives us a little preview into what we're going to be reading. And then next time when we read the story, after we learn some of these directions, you're going to be able to hear these words and recognize them all by yourself. Okay, pero vamos. So let's start with these lados de la caja, or the sides of the box. So we're going to be learning some different places, the sides of the box. Okay, so you can repeat the conmigo, repeat with me. So here's our box. So imagine our box here, the top of the box. So encima, on top. Encima, encima, say with me, encima. Under is abajo, abajo. Encima, abajo. Encima, abajo. Now, in front of, enfrente, enfrente, enfrente. Atrás. Behind, atrás, atrás, muy bien. And then we have two more. We have inside, dentro, dentro, dentro. And the last one is next to, al lado de, al lado de. Encima, abajo. Enfrente, atrás, dentro, al lado de, al lado de. Say this with me one more time. Encima, abajo, enfrente, atrás, dentro. Al lado de. Muy bien. Now I'm going to try to give you some directions and you try to remember and do the motions with me with your hands. So encima, abajo, encima, abajo, enfrente, enfrente. This one, listen close, it sounds like front in English. Enfrente, in front. Atrás, atrás, behind, atrás, dentro, dentro, inside, al lado de, Al lado de. Next to. Next to. Al lado de. Una vez más. Let's try it one more time. One more time. Encima. Abajo. Enfrente. Atrás. Dentro. Inside. Al lado de. Next to. Muy bien. We're going to practice this a little bit more later, but for now, we'll put it aside. And then we're going to do just a couple of direcciones. Not all of these on the page that you see today, but we're just going to do a couple. Okay? So we had derecha. Derecha, which means to the right. So if there are those of you who are just learning right and left, just try to follow along with me. So we have derecha, which is the right. Derecha. We have izquierda, left. Izquierda, left. Derecha. Izquierda. Derecha. Izquierda. Okay, muy bien. Una vez más with the box. Encima. Abajo. Enfrente. Atrás. Dentro. Al lado de. Next to. Muy bien. And the last directions we had were derecha. Right. Derecha. Izquierda. Left. Muy bien. Okay. So we're gonna kind of wrap it up there for today, but we have a game that we're gonna play for next time. So it's something I definitely want you to play at home in the meantime so you can practice. So first, with the different sides of the box, that's something you can definitely practice. If you have a box, if you want to use a table, you can have a ball or some other object, and you can practice giving some directions, and you have to put that object where you say it goes. So if you say it goes encima, practice, you put it on top. If you say abajo, you practice putting it under the table. If you say atrás, we practice behind. Enfrente, practice in front. Dentro, inside. That's when you would need to use a box for that because you can't put something inside a table. And al lado de, next to. So you can practice this with all kinds of things in your house. And then also with the direcciones, we're going to play a game a little bit more next time. But it's something you can start playing by, it's kind of like almost like a sign says game where you have to, one person has to give directions to the other person and they have to make you go different places around the room or around the house. So so you can play that in the meantime. We're going to play it a little bit more together. But for now, we're going to wrap up in our Spanish class for today. So muy buen trabajo. I'll see you at the next Spanish class. Gracias y adiós.